Merry Christmas. It's a great Christmas morning at the Mims house. We're ready for the grandchildren to come over and be with us and our children to be with us. It's just an unusual time. Usually our house would be filled with laughter and people running around, but due to COVID, everybody's at home and we're going to come together for some lunch. But the star of Christmas, of course, is Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. And do you know Jesus had three dads? The Bible said he was the son of David, right? His stepfather was Joseph, and he was the son of God, the Father. And not many people have three dads, but he did. And he had one mother who he was born. It's so important to realize that Jesus was born. He didn't come as a man. He was born because he was a human being. He didn't just show up as an apparition or something like that, or an angel. He was born in a natural way, and he was conceived in a supernatural way, born in a natural way, lived a life just like you do and like I do. And that's so important for us. He's God-man. The natures didn't mix, but they coexisted. And because he was man, he could save us from our sins. And in the Christmas story, he's given so many wonderful names. Let me just read a few. In Matthew, he's called Jesus. He's called Jesus Christ, the Messiah. He's called Emmanuel. He's called the King of the Jews. And isn't it interesting that he's called the King of the Jews by an angel, by prophecy, and Pilate later, when they were crucifying, called him King of the Jews. He's called the Shepherd, he's called the Lord, he's called the Savior. He's an infant, he's a child, he's all of the things that we need. He's the Son of God and the Son of Man. He didn't just appear, as I said, he came to be fully human. He was sent by the Father, and that was his focus, to do the will of the Father. And he was sent for us to trust him and to obey him and to follow him and to do his will. And I think it's wonderful. Jesus is absolutely unique. There's no other person in any other religion like Jesus Christ. Who else was born of a virgin? Who else was resurrected from the grave? Who else ascended to heaven? Not to say anything about him walking on water and things like this. He's the most unique person in history, and he's our Savior. He can save us because he's human, and he can come and do the rule and the authority that he has because he's divine. And we can never trust, serve, or love him enough, can we? That's what I think is Christmas time. He's our perfect Savior, our mediator. He's the one praying for us right now. He's the star of Christmas. He became like us so we could become like him one day. Isn't that just the most wonderful thing you've ever thought about? That one day you're going to be God-like. You're going to be glorified with the glory of God. And sharing that. Today, Christmas morning, Christmas day, whenever you're looking at this, just rejoice that Jesus Christ is our brother and our Savior and our King and our Lord, and he's coming back for us one day, not only for us to give us eternity, but for also to straighten out this world so we can live in peace for the reign of Christ on this earth. God bless you today. Have a merry, best Christmas that you've ever had. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, thank you for this day. We celebrate it because you sent your Son to be for us, to live and die for us, and to reveal you to us. For that we're ever thankful, evermore praising you. Lord Jesus, thank you and praise your name. And it's in your name we pray. Amen. God bless you. We'll see you tomorrow.